That's what that looks like up close.
Hey everyone, welcome to Watch Complications. I'm Brian. Consider subscribing if you like what you see, and links to my website, watchcomplications.com, and my Instagram are in the description below. This is a quick little video to talk about magnification. I do a lot of watch tinkering, making, modding, and if you're getting into it or you've been into it for a while, what type of magnification would be good to use? To start with, if you want something that's lower cost, what's some of the higher end stuff? But what works well? I want to share with you what my favorite headset is and the reasons why it's my favorite. It's not expensive, it's low cost. The Amazon affiliate link for the product is in the description below, but it's only about 30 bucks. And if you watch much of my channel, you know that I try a variety of types of tools and accessories when it comes to the watches and watchmaking stuff. Tools, I really recommend higher end stuff usually. And there are some circumstances where lower end stuff might make more sense, particularly if it works really well. And so there are some of the tools and accessories I have laying around that are the, you know, the cheap stuff, but they work fine. And in some cases, I might recommend something higher end. When it comes to headsets, you can find a crazy variety of headsets. There are loops that you sit on your head with a wire that wraps around. You can get some that are sort of like almost like suction cups on your glasses. You can get ones that are like boxed and like it's like blocks out other types of light except for what's coming in through the lenses. You name it, it's out there. And the cost is all over the map. There are a lot of people out there in watch modding or wanting to get into it and maybe aren't wanting to spend too much, don't want to go to the extreme yet. What makes sense is a practical headset that will work really well. That's what I want to share with you in this video is what my favorite one is. If you've watched many of my other videos or you were to go back and do so, you'll notice back here in the corner, there's a little leather tray that's from Vario. Almost always sitting there is my headset. And this is my favorite. It doesn't even have a brand name really. This is what the box looks like. I'll show you this stuff up close. It's number 989-2B2. Sounds like a song or something. But this is my favorite. I'll give you all the pros and cons that you might have with this particular headset. It costs about 30 bucks, but there's why it's my favorite. Really, it's that simple. I'm always sitting around. I spin around to my desk here. I want to look at something. I throw the headset on. I start looking around. It moves, rotates, and so you can get the magnification or even with your face. I wear glasses, people. I wear glasses. And it can be a little bit hard to find a set that works well with glasses. This has a nose piece that is quite a ways back from the actual magnification lens. And what's great about that is it slides on my face over my glasses, this elastic strap. I've had this for almost 3 years. And even though it was only 30 bucks, this hasn't given out on me yet. This is still my first one. Now, I take care of my stuff, but it's not like I'm really easy on this. I can always buy another one if I need to, but it's worked really well for me, and I highly recommend it. You can lift this up out of the way quickly, like if you're talking to someone. If you want to really entertain your family, you can just have this on your head, walk around the house as you're going between, let's say you want to go get a glass of water or something, get a snack. They really are entertained by how you look with this device. And as I've had this over the years, it's useful beyond just watches. So, for example, if you have a delicate necklace that's gotten tied up in knots, this is great for that. Maybe a splinter to remove from yourself or a loved one, then this can come in handy for getting that done well. So lots of other uses beyond just your watch modding. And then even once you've got this on, if you want to change to a different magnification, this goes all the way from 1 up to 3.5, you just pop the lens out, get the other lens, and then pop it back on. It's that simple. There's just so many quick, easy things about this headset that just make it, practical, applied, humble. And that's the kind of thing I like. But I want to show you a little bit more up close. We'll look at the box. We'll look at the two options for how this will fit to your face. And talk a little bit about the lenses and other features. So let's do that real quick and I'll send you on your way. What am I wearing today? It's my Christopher Ward C63 Sealander GMT Polar White. Let's do it. Okay, so this is what the box looks like. It's got tons of bits of information all over it, everything except a brand name. As I mentioned, it's got a number on it and just descriptive text, picture, that kind of stuff. All the features of it, which I'll just show you, and a couple uses, in terms of the application. you can use it for. It comes with a simple, you know, manual, you know, owner's instructions, that kind of stuff in English and Chinese. Simple box. And there are two types of head attachments that come with this. One option for wearing, you have the what they call bracket feet, which typical of glasses, sunglasses, there's a little bit of rubber on here to keep, you know, from slipping, that kind of thing. So pretty basic box, and I'm surprised I was able to find it. Yeah, it was in my basement somewhere with all my other sort of watch tool stuff. So I actually hung on to it, even though it's been a few years. Here's the headset. Speaking of watch modding, this watch you see here in the background, that is my Monty Python mod, and that's coming up. I started mentioning the features in the intro and why I like it. One, it slips over the head, even if you wear glasses, fairly easily. I like the elastic strap much better. You can size it perfectly for you, for easily putting on and off quickly, you know, and how tight you want that. It's not had any wear and tear on it to speak of, still elastic. I've, again, had this for like 3 years, and nothing has broken on this for me, and I've not necessarily treated it nicely, but I don't purposely throw it around, but at the same time, it's not broken in any way. If you were rough on it, sure, like anything else that's low-cost plastic, but I really like the elastic band. That's one thing of note. I wear glasses, as I mentioned, and so this has the space between the nose guard and the lens to give space for people wearing glasses. And you just can't beat that. This is quite comfortable. It doesn't get uncomfortable. If it does, that would be because maybe you've got the headband too tight, that kind of thing. I mentioned that the lenses easily pop on and off. I'll say more about the lenses in a second, but they do have the focus or the field of view on the lens. So this is the 2.5. They easily snap on and off. And you can do that while it's on your head. You don't have to take it off to switch out the lens. The lens arm does rotate, so you can get that in focus for your given situation fairly easily. There is a built-in LED light on this. I've never used it. This is actually pretty lightweight. This thing weighs almost nothing. That's another reason why I really like it. When it comes to headsets, this is a really light option. It'll be heavier if you put in batteries to use the LED light. You can see here's the on-off switch for it. Simple slide forward and back. Here's where the battery compartment is. It's on the inside. See the little clip here. Pull that down. It takes two AAA batteries. I've, again, never used it. No need to. Most people that are getting into watch modding are probably working in an area that has at least reasonable light. I have LED lighting around on my workbench. If I'm working at this desk, I have the photo video lights that I use for shooting videos like this one. So plenty of light around. I've not had a need for the forward-facing LED on the headset. Again, adding those couple batteries, two AAAs, not huge weight, but at least noticeable over time on the head. So that's your choice if you would want to use those or not. You can see there's a little bit of flexibility and rotation here where the strap or the brackets, typical of glasses, connect. That actually really helps with the overall comfort of this headset, because depending on how tight you have this, or if you have the other feet on this, it kind of wraps a little bit more to the contours of your head and stays comfortable. And again, with the padding here as well, I've never had an issue of comfort. A lot of that has to do with the curved padding here. It's kind of, again, a rubber sort of surface. Doesn't leave imprints on your head, I guess, unless you strap this thing on really tight. But comfort is one of the main things whenever you're dealing with watch making, modding, whatever, you're sitting around for an hour or two, three at a time with this thing on. It's got to be lightweight, comfortable, and give you what you need in terms of focus. For me, this has met most of the everyday needs that I have had. And so overall wearability, comfort, for me, that's the elastic strap. The fact that these rotate, the padding and curve here, nose guard works really well and allows for my glasses to remain on, and then a variety of lens types that fit into this. Speaking of the lenses, what comes with this particular headset? If you were just getting into watchmaking or modding and you were reading about stuff online, a lot of people are going to say 4x is the best magnification or the most common one, and that's true. It's one of the more common ones, and you could go for something a little bit, you know, quote unquote higher end. You could go with a loop, Of course, this wraps around your head in a particular way so it stays on your face. And of course, this can be put against your eye directly or against glasses as well. But this is a Bausch & Lomb 4X. I also have a 10X. Those are the two very common ones, which up close, 4X, really up close, sort of crazy macro for the tiniest of details. That's the 10X. So you might get one or two of those. They're not crazy expensive either. But for most uses, everyday stuff, what's in this kit is almost everything I need. And usually I have something like the 2.5 times, the 2.5 magnification on. It's enough for almost every scenario. But what you get with this kit is 1, 1.5, 2, 2.5, and 3.5. So this takes you from 1 up to 3.5. And then if you really want to get more serious about things, maybe get a 4 from Bausch & Lomb. Most people doing typical modding don't need a 10. But if you're going to get into serious watchmaking, then you would want a variety. Just anyway, you want a variety of all kinds of tools, including magnification, where you might want something that's a little bit closer. But this covers almost every scenario you could have as a basic watch modder, or if you're getting into that sort of stuff. Now, I take care of my tools. Like I said, I haven't beaten this up a lot. It's always on my desk, though. There's rarely a day where I don't put this on at least once for a period of time. And not only that, I've had this for 3 years. If you look at the Amazon page of this one that I've linked specifically, the one I bought, it's got a lot of reviews. It's got overall about a 4.5 star rating. This has generally held up well, been reasonable quality. It's only $30. And it's, for me personally, stood the test of time. If it broke after 3 to 5 years, okay, I'll get another one. I would buy this again. And that's the main thing when it comes to watch tools is, did it serve its purpose? Did it work well? Was it comfortable, useful, practical? And then when it comes to cost, okay, so what? If something on this happens to break, I don't see that happening anytime soon. I thought maybe the elastic might give out over time. It hasn't. If you're getting into tinkering with watches or want to replace the magnification because you're not happy with it in some way, my personal recommendation is give this one a try. One last thing I'll mention is in terms of how they stay clean. They stay fairly clean, like any kind of lens. You got to wipe it up once in a while, and just a standard microfiber cloth does the trick. All right, also, thanks for joining me in this quick little review slash really tip about what my favorite headset is. Don't have to break the bank. It's got all the bells and whistles that I like and appreciate. It's held up for me. If you're in need of a headset, want to try something different than what you currently have going on, give this a try. Links in the description below. If you want more Watch Complications content, then hit the subscribe button, bell if you want updates. Links to my Instagram and website, watchcomplications.com, are in the description below. I'm Brian. I'm out.